tell us all about it is Heather Taylor. She's a zookeeper here, and we're kind of on top of this little ledge in order to be able to see these little guys today because they're just hanging out in the shade. It's hot out here, Heather.
So they are adapted to be in temperatures a lot hotter than this. They are from the African savanna, so they definitely can handle the heat a lot better than us. But this new huge exhibit allows them the opportunity for choice to be where they choose to be. Unfortunately, we just missed them. They were hanging out in their man-built wall over there. But as you can see from the enclosure, they are architects. And they have done their own wallows and put them in spots where they definitely prefer. But yeah, they're lounging over there in the shade. But again, this large exhibit really allows them the opportunity to do that. So we just give them that choice.
Yeah, and there's four of them, all girls. Mom and three daughters?
Mom and a son and two daughters.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
So we have Zara, Zephyr, Zoe and Zelda, all Z names.
Okay, so they can speak to us by their body language and by the hair on their body. Can you kind of explain a little bit about that and just give us some interesting facts about warthogs?
Absolutely. So you can tell they're all pretty relaxed and comfortable right now in their environment. But if they were under a little bit of distress or, you know, signs of nervousness, which sometimes they get because they are a prey item, essentially. So that's what keeps them alive. But so the tail would flick up, their mane, which they actually have manes like their neighbors over here, lions. So the mane actually sticks up, and that would alert the others in the group that, you know, there is some danger. But as you can tell, they are completely comfortable right now, even with their neighbors, the lions, right next to them.
I think a lot of people have this, I don't know if it's a misconception or not, but believe that they have a funny sense of humor. Do you find that? I mean, do you see them with their own personality?
Absolutely.
What are they like?
They definitely have their own personalities. I don't want to say I have favorites, but Zephyr the male is so affectionate, and he really enjoys interaction. And that's another great feature of this exhibit that I love is this glass viewing wall right here that we're standing on. So you can see, I've just cleaned the glass, but down here there's definitely evidence of them putting their cute little adorable muddy snouts. And so the guests can actually get so up close and personal and interact. And that's one of the great features of this new exhibit. And we can really see that interaction, and it's so enriching for them to be able to do that guest interaction. Obviously, the guests love it as well. Who doesn't want to get super close to these guys?
Oh my goodness. They're so cute, and they're not afraid of people. I love that.
Yeah. And this exhibit also has tons of different features that we're so proud of. So it has built-in heaters. So we actually have some lower ones over there where they've liked to dig and some up there. Mm-hmm. So on those cooler nights, which I know we all cannot wait for to come around again, they'll be able to have climate controlled out here. We also have a wonderful life support system that comes out and checks the water, make sure they have amazing drinking water, and they have different water features built into the rock so they can have opportunity for that fresh water constantly on exhibit. You can see the fallen tree. They love to root around and dig on that. Their tusks can actually grow over 10 inches.
Wow.
And they use those to dig around in the dirt to find earthworms, other invertebrates, and get roots. And you can tell evidence of that everywhere all over this exhibit that's allowing for those natural behaviors.
Wow.
So this is just a real honor, and honestly, all of it is because of our community and Measure Z.
We could tell that they love it as well, and their cousin Pumbaa would be very jealous.
Yes, he
very
definitely
jealous.
Wants to come live here
exactly.
with them. I don't know if Zephyr wants to share, though.
I wouldn't either. Good for Zephyr. Thanks so much, Heather. I appreciate your
time. It was a pleasure.
All
Thank
right.
you, guys, and we look forward to having you come and visit us soon.
All right, our time now is 6:19. Still ahead here. We all try and work hard, but do you know where the hardest working Americans live? It's not here. More on this next.